Hello everyone, welcome to the second lecture of NLPP problem. In this lecture here we will see how the categorization of NLPP problems are made, and that can be understood with the help of this tree diagram. If you will see, NLPP problem is of two types: either NLPP problem have the constraint or NLPP problem does not have the constraint. That is called NLPP problem without constraint. If you see NLPP problem without constraint, that type of problem has only one type, and that is considered as the basic problem. If you see NLPP problem with constraint, now again question come whether that constraint has equality sign or inequality sign. If NLPP problem has equality sign, then that can be solved with the help of Lagrangian multiplier. But if it has inequality sign, then it can be solved with the help of Kantaker method. Again, the Lagrangian multiplier problem has a four categorization, that is one constraint, two variable, one constraint, three variable, two constraint and two variable, two constraint and three variable. These are the four types of problems are there that comes under Lagrangian multiplier. But if we see inequality constraint problem, which is solved with the help of Kantaker method, it has only two type: one constraint, two variable, and another one is two constraint and two variable. So this is the graph, or here we can say this is a tree diagram that shows how the categorization of the problems are made. Now we'll see how the exercise are formed. The basic problem are placed in exercise number 1. Whether exercise number 2 contain one constraint, two variable problem, exercise 3 contain one constraint, three variable problem, exercise 4 contain two constraint and two variable, exercise 5 contain two constraint and three variable. Now the last two exercises contain one constraint and two variable, two constraint and two variable by Kantaker method. This is how the classification of the problem and exercises are formed. Thank you.